Hello friends, welcome to SS Unitech. My name is Sushil Singh and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today I gonna discuss about pivot operator and dynamic pivot operator. So first of all, we need to discuss about the pivot. So what is pivot? Pivot is a SQL Server operator that can be used to turn unique values from one column to multiple columns in our output. Basically, it's a rotation of table. So what it means? Let's move to another slide where we will understand. So this is our slide. As you can see, we have input table and it contains five columns. First is ID, second is customer ID, then mobile, and then date, and then duration. In our output, we can see we have only four columns. First is customer ID and then the mobile number, and we can see it's available in our input. But next two columns are coming from date. We can see we can turn unique values from date column in our output. How we can achieve this output? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio to write the query and get the output. As I am using SQL 2014, you may have another versions of SQL Server, but query would be same for all the versions. First of all, we need to create the table. So I wanna create the table. Table has been created successfully. And then I wanna execute insert a statement and insert some record on it. So three rows affected, and we can select and we can check. So data is available as I have displayed in our slide. First of all, we need to write the pivot operator. So for using pivot operator, we have to specify pivot and then open bracket, and inside the bracket we have to use that column by which we want to aggregate the values. So we want to sum of these duration, then for which column we want to turn the unique values, we have to specify over here. So call date is the our column, and then we have to use in operator, then again open the bracket, and inside the bracket we have to specify the values. So here we can see we have two unique values. First is 24318 and second 25318. So we have to specify over here. So 2018 3 24, and then 2018 3 25. We have to specify in our select statement as well. We want to get four columns. First is customer ID and then the mobile number. So we can see mobile number, customer ID, and then two columns, and we have 24, so we have to specify 24. And now we can execute. We are getting some error, so we have to specify a alias name for this pivot operator, as I am using PVT. Now we can execute and we can see. So here we can see it's not going to return as we want in our slide. So in our slide we can see we have only one row by which we are getting exact same output, but here we are getting three rows. So why it's not going to return as same output as we want? Because in our table we have a ID column, and this ID column is not used in our output. If we don't want to use ID column in our output, so we have to remove this column from our select statement. So we have to select only those values which are going to used in our pivot operator. So we have to use only four columns. So first is customer ID, then the mobile, and then the call date, and then the duration. So we have to use duration, and then we have to set in a derived table, and we have to put an alias name for this derived table, and we can execute this query. And now we can compare between our slide and in our output. So here we are getting same output as we want. So I hope you have understand how we can use pivot operator. If we have a scenario by which date column values is going to increase on daily basis, then how we can write a query by which there is no need to put changes on daily basis. So let's move to another slide where we will discuss. So here we can see we have an input table and it contains six columns. First is customer ID, then the customer name, then the mobile number, call date, start time, then the duration of that call. And in our output, we can see customer ID, name, and mobile number is also present in our input table, but we want to turn the unique values from call date column in our input to our output. In our output, we have 23.18 and 21.318, 22.318. And in input table, we can see we have 20, 21 and 22, these three unique values in call date column. So how we can write a dynamic pivot by which we can achieve this output? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio, where we will discuss how we can write the query. Now I want to execute this create statement. Table has been created successfully. Then I want to insert some record on it. So we can execute this query. And here 6 rows affected. So 6 rows has been inserted in our table. So we can execute and we can compare between slides. So these metadata are same. So first of all, we need to put unique values from this table to a temporary table. So we can choose distinct keyword and then call date into as temp. So unique values will be inserted in our table. So now we have to declare a variable, declare at the rate. This is the column name. So we have to use at the rate call. And this is varchar max. Here we can see we have to use a loop by which we can create the column dynamically. So we have to use while exist. So I am going to check the values, whether these values are present in our temporary table, then this loop will be executed. And here begin and end. So here we need to select the first row. So we have to use top operator, top one, and then from this temporary table, and we need to assign in our column variable. So column variable is equals to at the rate column. Then we need to concatenate. So first of all, we have to specify our bracket. Then we have to cast and then call date is our column name as varchar 20. And then again, we need to close and then put comma. So it's going to set the values in our column variable, and then we need to delete top one from temporary table. So it will delete our first row. And now I gonna select and we can check. So table has been created already. So we need to, so here it's going to return null value because we have to specify blank at the starting. But at this time we don't have any value in this temporary table. So we have to drop and recreate, and then we need to execute. And here we can execute and we can see it's going to return the value. But here we can see we have an extra comma. So we have to remove that comma. So we need to select values from left of this variable call. And then we need to check the length. And we need to subtract 1 and it will set the value. So we can execute and we can see comma has been eliminated. So we have to select as well. So now we can execute and we can check. So here we can see our column is created successfully. So next we need to write a dynamic SQL by which we can put the pivot operator. We need to declare one more variable we can call as SQL and then varchar max. First of all, we need to initialize as blank. So first we know how we can write pivot operator. So we can write select from then our table name. So what is our table name? Dynamic pivot table is our table name. So we have to specify over here. So this is our table. And in our select statement, we need to select only 3 columns as we have displayed in our slide. First is customer ID. So this is customer ID, then the name, and then the mobile number. So these 3 columns are going to select over here. And then we need to concatenate. So we have to use plus and then @SQL. So this is our dynamically created columns. As we have discussed, we have to select only those rows which are going to used in our pivot operator. So we need to eliminate those rows which are not part of pivot operator. So we have to use all these three columns and then the call date, and then we have one more column which is duration. So duration, so these columns are required, so we have to use only these columns in our select statement. So here we can see we have done almost. So we need to use pivot and then brackets, and here we need to put sum of duration, and then we have to use for, and we have to specify call date, and then in we have to use bracket, and inside the bracket we have to use our column. So this is our columns, and here we need to use an alias name. So I am going to put these values in our dynamic SQL. So this is, and then we need to put plus sign over here, and over here put any space, and then comma, then plus, then again plus here we need to set, and then again plus sign, and then, and I am going to set these values in our SQL variable. Select, and we can check what values are present in our SQL variable. So here we can see we have this statement. We can copy, we can paste. We are not getting the column names over here. We have to use @column. Now I am going to execute, and we can, now we can select, copy, paste it over here. And now I am going to execute. As we can see, we are going to get the output. So first of all, we have to use execute this dynamic SQL, and then we can see, now we can see we are going to get the output. I hope you have understand how we can get the output by using dynamic pivot operator. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel for many more videos, and press bell icon to get all the notifications for new videos. If you need these scripts, it will be available on my Facebook page. You can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching.